Among art songs written by Latin American composers, it's worth highlighting and providing a survey of compositions for voice and piano by the Mexican composer Manuel Ponce, who wrote art songs in Spanish, Italian, French, English, and German. Existing research on Ponce's music shows the need to do further study and performance of the composer's vocal music, which deserves to be recognized as an important contribution to the corpus of Latin American art song. The first part of the lecture will provide concise biographical information on Ponce, highlighting his prominent role in the development of Mexican music. In his biography of the composer, Pablo Castellanos proposed a classification of Ponce's work into Romantic and Modernist stages. The first period included Ponce's childhood and early training in Mexico, study abroad in Italy and Germany, a two-year exile in Cuba, and professional activities up to 1924, while the modernist phase consisted of the composer's nine-year stay in Paris from 1925 to 1934, and his last 14 years in Mexico City. Ponce's advocacy of canciones mexicanas and the composer's interest in Mexican folk music will be mentioned during the overview of his Romantic period. Following an overview of Ponce's life, I will provide an annotated catalog of the composer's sets of art songs, in which the composer set music to more than 30 poems in 5 different languages by 14 poets from 7 nationalities. Ponce's eclectic sets of art songs are a clear representation of the composer's cosmopolitan interest in setting to music works by Latin American, European, and Asian poets. Thus, Ponce's syncretic ideology and universalism demonstrates the diverse topics that he incorporated into his songs, showcasing his preference towards the belief in the universality of the musical and human experience, as a way to depict the eclectic identity and diversity of Latin America. The Mexican composer Manuel Ponce was born on December 8th of 1882 in Fresnillo, a town located 60 miles away from the capital of the state of Zacatecas. A few months later, the Ponces moved back to their hometown of Aguascalientes, where Manuel spent most of his childhood together with his 11 older siblings. The son of Don Felipe Ponce and María de Jesús Cuellar, Manuel showed musical talent from an early age. Noticing his musical interest, Manuel's older sister Josefina taught him his first piano lessons. At age 10, he enrolled in piano lessons with Cipriano Avila. Manuel became a member of church choirs, and soon he started playing the organ during Catholic services at local churches. Besides his local church activities, Manuel also enjoyed spending time at the annual state fair of San Marcos, where he had his first encounter with vernacular songs from different regions of the country. When he was 18 years old, Ponce felt that the town of Aguascalientes had limited opportunities left for his artistic growth, and he made the decision to move to Mexico City. After taking some private piano and theory lessons, he decided to enroll in Mexico's National Conservatory of Music. Ponce had mixed feelings regarding his decision to move to Mexico City. He composed his first salon pieces for the piano, such as mazurkas, gavottes, and other dances. Taking part in the thriving cultural environment of the capital of Mexico, Ponce frequented social gatherings that were organized by friends with artistic backgrounds. On the other hand, he perceived that the pace of his studies at the National Conservatory of Music wasn't meeting his expectations, so he decided to move to Europe. After a long transatlantic trip, Ponce continued his studies in Italy. Ponce's compositions from this period are deeply rooted in the long-lasting influence of Romantic pianist composers, such as Chopin and Liszt. In Bologna's Liceo Rossini, the young Mexican composer took some composition lessons with Enrico Bossi, who regarded some of Ponce's early works as too old-fashioned. However, Bossi noticed the student's potential, and he recommended that he received further instruction from the pianist Luigi Torchi and the composer Cesare Dall'Olio, who was one of Puccini's pupils. Following Dall'Olio's death in 1905, Ponce moved to Berlin and enrolled at the Stern Conservatory of Music, where he took piano lessons with Martin Krause, a piano pedagogue and one of Franz Liszt's late pupils. During his year-long stay in Berlin, Ponce noticed that his studio classmates were interested in folk music, and at the time of their Mexican colleague's farewell, they gave him a copy of Albert Friedendahl's Stimme der Völker, a collection of folk songs that included a chapter on Mexican music. Members of Krause's studio enthusiastically listened to some of Ponce's first arrangements of Mexican popular songs, such as harmonizations of Marchita el Alma, Veno Luna, La Barca del Marino, and Perdí un Amor. Upon his return to Mexico in 1907, Ponce resumed his teaching activities. He kept an active private studio and obtained a piano professor position at the National Conservatory, where his students premiered the music of Debussy in Mexico. One of Ponce's pupils was a young boy named Carlos Chavez, who later became one of Mexico's most prominent composers. Chavez performed Claque de Lion from the Suite Bergamasque in an old Debussy piano recital. In addition to his teaching and compositional activities, Ponce gave lectures that focused on his research on Mexican popular sound. Some of them were published in magazines from Mexico City. One of these lectures occurred in August of 1912, where the composer stated that, quote, "I consider it the duty of every Mexican composer to ennoble the music of their country, giving it artistic form, dressing it with polyphonic glory, and preserving with love the popular melodies which are the expression of the national soul." Inspired by collections of vernacular music, Ponce composed stylized transcriptions and original pieces that recaptured the sonority of Mexican popular songs. During this time, Ponce began to explore the use of large forms, and also quoted Mexican canciones in some of his piano works. As a result of his research, Ponce outlined the characteristic features of Mexican song. He concluded that the standard canción mexicana is in binary form, leading to a dramatic climax at the B section. These songs tend to have a harmonic motion from the tonic to the dominant, and they are often in four-part harmony with an arch-like melodic contour. The expression of love is a central topic in many of these compositions, such as in Ponce's set of 12 Canciones Mexicanas, published in 1912. One of these love songs was Estrellita, which undoubtedly became the composer's best known and most performed song. Also during this time, Ponce composed his first art songs in foreign languages. Two of them were in German, in which he used the Breit über mein Haupt, Dein schwarzes Haar, and Ihr Lärchen poems by Adolf von Schack. 2 years after the publication of his Canciones Mexicanas, Ponce wrote Si tu pouvais venir, a lyrical song in French with lyrics by the Swiss poet Charles Fuster. Also in 1914, he wrote markings that suggest tempo rubato in O bisogno, a song in Italian with a poem by Ada Negri. During his tenure in the 1910s at Mexico's National Conservatory, Ponce met the voice student Clementina Morel, a Mexican mezzo-soprano of French descent, whose parents were the French businessman Sarrazin Morel and Columba Villagra, a Mexican woman from the capital of the state of Coahuila. Reminiscing Robert Schumann's increased interest in lyric composition after he met his wife Clara Schumann, Clema also became the inspiration of and dedicatee of most of Ponce's vocal works since the start of their relationship in 1913. However, the couple soon experienced physical distance when Manuel joined a group of self-exiled Mexican artists who left their country as a result of social and political instability, which was provoked by the Mexican Revolution of the 1910s. Ponce lived in Cuba from 1915 to 1917, keeping a long-distance relationship with Clema through love letters, such as one that he sent her soon before his return to Mexico. Quote, Havana, Cuba, April 4 of 1917. Ponce to Clema Morel. And the sweet emotion that your memory arouses, joins with the emotion of the music that I have been hearing in my mind. And now, my soul speaks with yours in the peace of the evening, speaking and singing all the phrases of love. Only a couple of months after this letter, Ponce moved back to Mexico and got married to Clema in September of 1917. She kept all the love letters that her fiancé had sent her, and she became Ponce's romantic partner and musical collaborator. The composer dedicated several of his pieces to her, such as The Romance of Love for piano. Clema also premiered most of her husband's vocal works, and she aimed to promote the publication of her husband's compositions. In 1925, the Ponces moved to Paris, where they remained for the next 8 years, and the composer had first-hand contact with some of the most prominent artists of his time. At age 42, Ponce had the ambition to update his compositional language and decided to study under the guidance of Paul Ducas at the École Normale de Musique de Paris. The composer of L'Apprentis Sorcier complimented his pupil's progress during his studies in Paris, stating that, quote, "The compositions of Ponce have the stamp of the most distinguished talent. They cannot be classified according to any scholastic criteria. I would feel reticent to assign him a grade, even if it was the highest one, in order to express my satisfaction at having had a disciple so outstanding and personal." Ponce's compositions from his Parisian period reveal a synthesis of a wide variety of influences that include elements of Spanish and Latin American music, with some references to French Impressionism. Ponce's harmonic vocabulary became increasingly chromatic, exploring the use of polychords and unresolved dissonances in his sets of art songs. In the 1930s, Ponce's first four song sets were performed in Paris by Clema and the Russian Jewish pianist Julian Krain, who was a member of Manuel's circle of friends. The event took place at the École Normale de Musique, where in a concert review published in Le Figaro, Musset stated that, quote, "The influence of the French masters is noticeable in the melody. Ponce uses a cosmopolitan language with a craft worth of distinction." In 1933, Ponce returned to Mexico, where he lived for the remainder of his life. There he composed his last three sets of art songs, as well as his final orchestral, chamber, and solo works. As a professor and lecturer at some of Mexico City's most important institutions, Ponce became a pioneer in ethnomusicological studies in Mexico. During his lifetime, Ponce received multiple medals by institutions from several Mexican states, and he was awarded membership positions in Argentinian, Costa Rican, and Cuban associations. In a ceremony that took place a couple of months before Ponce's death, the prominent Mexican composer Carlos Chavez praised the achievements of his teacher, who he considered as one of the first explorers of popular Mexican art. Suffering of poor health conditions during the last years of his life, Ponce died in April of 1948. Most of Ponce's poets were contemporaries of him, and the composer selected several works from Latin American poets who were associated with modernism, a trend that occurred in the last decades of the 19th century and the beginning of the 20th century. Originally designed to label the writings of the Nicaraguan poet Rubén Darío, Hispanic modernism favored verbal eloquence, exoticism, and universalism. Ponce's universalist ideology is shown through his heterogeneous choice of poems. Ponce's set of the songs is in English, "I Plucked Your Flower, O World," and "One Morning in the Flower Garden," with Spanish and French versions written by the Cuban poet Mariano Brühl. The composer set music to poems from the Gardener collection by Rabindranath Tagore. A contemporary of Ponce, the Indian poet Tagore studied both Oriental and Western poetry, and believed that universalism should be the strategy to deal with arrogant nationalism. Using the metaphor of a rose to describe the individuality of different cultures in relation to his universalist ideology, Tagore stated that, quote, "As the mission of the rose lies in the unfoldment of the petals, which implies distinctness, so the rose of humanity is perfect only when the diverse races and the nations have evolved their perfect distinct characteristics, but all attached to the stem of humanity by the bond of love." The 1913 Nobel Prize in Literature was awarded to Tagore, the first recipient of this award outside of Europe, who frequently described the beauty of nature, often linking the image of flowers with women's existence. In the poem called "I Plucked Your Flower, O World," Tagore recalls the temporality of life, relating the pain of life to a thorn prick. Continuing on the same mood, "One Morning in the Flower Garden" is a poem where Tagore incorporates the image of a lotus flower as a symbol of feminine purity. In an effort to match the poetic images of faded flowers and thorns, Ponce avoids providing a clear tonal center in his set of two poems, relying on chromaticism and unresolved harmonic progressions. In "I Plucked Your Flower, O World," the composer frequently incorporates planing on ascending and descending ninth chords. On the other hand, the second song contains open arpeggios with polychords that move in contrary motion. Moreover, the composer inserts some displaced accents that disrupt the suavissimo mood. Mariano Brull was a Cuban poet that was affiliated to the Hispanic Modernist movement. Brull spent part of his life in Spain and France, where he collaborated with Ponce in multiple projects, such as the 1928 edition of the Gaceta Musical, a Paris-based music periodical in Spanish. Ponce dedicated the first song of the set to Andrés Segovia, who was one of the most prominent Spanish guitar players of the 20th century. Ponce's first song is an ode to Granada, the capital of Andalusia, and Al-Andalus became the Arabic name for this southern region of Spain, which fell under Muslim rule from the 8th century, and ended with the fall of the Granada Emirate in 1492. Granada was the capital of this emirate, and Mercedes Garcia argues that the fact that an Arabic and Muslim tradition existed in southern Spain constitutes a very notable singularity with respect to other European regions. Ponce's Granada includes allusions to the arabesque singing of the cantejondo from southern Spain. The Moors introduced cantejondo to Spain when they conquered the Iberian Peninsula at the beginning of the 8th century. As Spain was under Moorish rule, Spanish music incorporated ornamental figures which are found in Oriental and Persian music. The most impressive architectural landmark of Granada's Muslim tradition is the Palace of the Alhambra. The Muslim Nasrid dynasty built this palace from 1238 to 1492, which became a staple of its political and cultural power. The Nasrids covered the walls and ceilings of the Alhambra with ornate arabesque decorations, which beautified this architectural milestone. Similar to the Alhambra palace's architecture, Ponce inserts decorations to his Granada song from three poems by Brull. For instance, the scherzando chords of measures 28 through 32 are full of mordents, which bring up to mind the ornamentation of the Moorish construction. Moreover, seventh chords and chromatic motion are additional elements of this decorated texture. Mariano Brull's Granada has five stanzas. In Ponce's musical setting of the poem, the topic of the strum guitar is found on the first and last stanzas. On the other hand, quartet chords are prominent in the un populento second stanza, whereas in the next stanza, Ponce makes use of arabesques that lead to some quintuplets in the piano part, causing a sense of metric shift to double meter in the piano postlude, as the composer highlights the first and third beats of the measure. After a return to the strum guitar topic, the final piano postlude contains a restatement of the quintuplet figuration. Ponce also recaptures the sound of each of the open strings of the guitar, from lowest to highest, in the piano part of his Granada Arzón, twice during the second stanza, and a final allusion in the last two measures of the piano postlude. The study of gradations of musical contour has been important to discuss the compositions with evocations of choral imagery. Concerning musical contour, the Gottesman states that global characteristics of the choral topic include repetition and sequencing of musical material, both in terms of phrase and arpeggiated sweeping gestures. She points out parallelisms between the shaping of musical phrases and the motion of waves in the ocean, regarding these musical gestures as a series of multiple suites. Inspired by a century-long tradition of pianistic evocations of water, Ponce incorporates this musical gesture in his Por el Hilo del Río Arzón, the second one of the set from three poems by Brühl. In the Por el Hilo del Río poem, the Cuban poet Mariano Brühl used the metaphor of water as a depiction of a journey. Ponce's stream of fluctuating arpeggios alludes to the poetic persona's desire to escape to a different place. The poem's references to crazy water, dead water, muddy water allude to the conflicted psychological state of the narrator and the potential allegory of water as a symbol of death. Ponce musically depicted the content of the poem with the use of continuous chromatic arpeggios, frequent dynamic and melodic contour changes, and the lack of a clear tonal center. Ponce's piano postlude builds up to a plumoso splash of sound that gradually loses momentum and fades away. In his Cuban-inspired works, Ponce frequently used rhythmic ostinatos. One of the most prominent is the Cinquillo Cubano, a pattern that includes two statements of an eighth note followed by two 16th notes, in which the third note is tied to the eighth note of the next beat. This syncopated pattern is found in many Cuban dances, and Ponce incorporated it in several of his works. The pattern of the Cinquillo Cubano is also found in some arzones by Ponce, such as Espera, Insomnio, and Ansoir. Both Espera and Insomnio have constant cinquillo patterns, as well as an A section in the minor mode followed by a B section in a parallel major key. Another example of the cinquillo cubano is the ostinato added note and 7 chords of measures 20 through 31 and 42-49 of Verdi Alago, the last song of the set of three poems by Brühl. The syncopated left-hand pattern of these sections is referred as anticipated bass in Cuban popular music, and it can be regarded as a rhythmic augmentation of the Cuban cinquillo or a tiled 16-note version of the habanera dance rhythm. This elided bass pattern had its roots in Afro-Cuban popular music. In his Verde Alago poem, the Cuban writer Mariano Brühl explored the rich sound of the consonants of the Spanish language. He particularly focused on the sound of the R and B consonants, as in Ponce's measures 26 through 28 of Ponce's setting, where the poet explores the characteristic sound of the rolled R in Spanish. In addition, the title and many of the lines of this poem have words that have the letter V, such as verde, virgen, vengo, and verdura. The title of this poem by Brühl is a made-up word, where he combines two words that have real meaning in the Spanish language, verde, which means green, and halago, compliment. The Cuban poet referred to his made-up words as gitanjáforas, which he chose for their phonetic sound rather than for their real meaning. Brühl used two gitanjáforas with the letter V in the Verde Alago poem, verdularia and verdumbre, which doesn't exist in the vocabulary of the Spanish language. Ponce set music to six poems from the Spanish Renaissance Cancionero Musical de Palacio. The text of Mas Quiero Morir por Veros is by the 15th century Spanish poet and composer Juan de la Encina, who was the author of multiple villancicos, an important genre in Spanish Renaissance music. Ponce also selected five anonymous poems from the Palace Songbook, Zahareja del Cazar, De las Sierras, Sol Sol Gigi, Desciende el Valle, and Tres Morillas. For his penultimate set of songs, Ponce selected six poems from Asenjo Barbieri's edition of the Cancionero Musical de Palacio. The Cancionero's manuscript was discovered towards the end of the 19th century by Gregorio Cruzada at the Palacio Real in Madrid, Spain. The Cancionero Musical de Palacio is the most comprehensive collection of Spanish music from the Renaissance period. The Cancionero contains almost 500 songs, with part songs that were composed between the 15th and 16th centuries. This period of time has been defined as Spain's Siglo de Oro, or Golden Age, as it has been defined as an era of great artistic and cultural productivity when Spain enjoyed a prestige unequaled in her history. Ponce's setting of Mas Quiero Morir por Veros is in ABA form. The middle section of this piece deals with the topic of courtly love, alluding to the battles of a Spanish knight. The piano part in measures 18 through 30 recaptures the sound of the guitar, an instrument of paramount significance in Spanish music, as the ostinato pedal notes in the bass line imply the sound of the lowest string of the guitar. In the six archaic poems, Ponce recaptures modal sonorities, which evocate music from the Renaissance period. At the beginning of Mas Quiero Morir por Veros, Ponce incorporates the G Aeolian mode. González Martínez's poetry has multiple allusions to the sea, earth, and sky. In his metaphorical language, the poet frequently refers to the sea as a signifier of joy and death. During the 1920s, Ponce and the Mexican modernist writer Enrique González Martínez collaborated in the Mexico Moderno magazine from Mexico City. Almost 2 decades after this project, Ponce set music to 3 poems by González Martínez, Nocturno de las Rosas, Onda, en la despedida. In Nocturno de las Rosas, sorrow is depicted by painful ostinato seconds in the key of F minor with occasional whole tone references, whereas hope is set in the major mode. In the next song, an allusion to water is made by pairing a barcarolle pattern in the bass line with undulating pentatonic arpeggios. Most barcarolles have a characteristic long short rhythmic pattern set in 6/8 meter, and had been favored by composers such as Chopin, Mendelssohn, Fauré, Offenbach, among others. Before the Onda art song, Ponce had previously composed solo piano barcarolles, such as the second movement of his Cuban suite, as well as his Mexican barcarolle Xochimilco. Similarly to barcarolle's longtime association with the gondolas of Venice, Ponce titled his Mexican barcarolle after the Trajineras, which are colorfully decorated wooden boats that float on the canals of the Xochimilco Lake, located about 17 miles south of Mexico City. To complete his last set of songs, Ponce provided constant guitar-like pedal arpeggiations to embellish the pedal points of an ascending chromatic bassline in Despedida. The polymetric setting and constantly changing harmonies of this true composed song relate to a sense of departure towards death, whereas the static and slow-paced final section refers to a last greeting and final farewell. Ponce's eclectic sets of art songs are a clear representation of the composer's synthesis of heterogeneous and multicultural elements, where he set music to poems by Latin American, European, and Asian writers. Ponce's compositions for voice and piano clearly illustrate the composer's strong interest in nationalism and universalism. Attracted to the local popular songs of his country, he composed and arranged around 150 canciones mexicanas that depict his interest in Mexican nationalism. Ponce's arrangements and stylizations of popular songs peaked during the 1910s, a time when he took part at several lectures that pointed out the significance of depicting a national identity through popular songs. After living in different countries and assimilating diverse influences from multiple backgrounds, Ponce's composition of Mexican popular songs significantly decreased during his modernist period. On the other hand, the composer's eclectic sets of art songs are a clear representation of the composer's synthesis of heterogeneous and multicultural elements, where he set music to selected poems by Latin American, European, and Asian writers. Thus, Ponce's syncretic ideology and universalism perfectly aligned with Rabindranath Tagore's, showing the preference towards the belief in the universality of the musical and human experience, while simultaneously appreciating diverse and unique characteristics of different cultures.
Thank you. liberty.